MTV, here we are on the set of my first ever solo video. I'm really glad you can join me. I've just been into hair and makeup, and this is my first of four different looks. One's going to be sort of a natural, very simple look. There's going to be two very sort of glamorous, very dark eyes and sassy looks. And then the other one, I'm not too sure what the other one's like actually. The guy who's doing the video today is called Tim Royce, and he's a fab guy. He's done Emma Bunton's Free Me video. And Holly Valance, he's worked with Holly Valance.
Here in fantastic North London, just setting up for our first shot, first of many. We've got 2 days to go.
He's got a really, really good vision, and I've seen the videos that he's done in the past, and the lighting he uses, and he just makes everything look so beautiful and glamorous.
Looking forward to this because it's her first outing as a solo artist from S Club. I think she's really hyped up for it. I'm really hyped up for it. The crew is all ready for it, and so we're going to make something really fantastic.
Well, my LAX has just turned up and he is extremely, extremely gorgeous.
And I'm playing her ex. A bit weird playing someone's ex when you haven't even been out with them.
Basically, it's a catwalk and he is going to be in the audience and I'm sort of playing to him.
I'm meant to be popping up in the video just as her ex, wishing that I could get her back, and she's basically sticking a finger up at me.
He's cute, so it should be good.
Doing the music video for the girl who's been voted sexiest woman in the world, well, it always makes my mates a little bit jealous.
Right, I've got to go. I've got to go and get changed because we're going to do the first shot of my video. And I will see you on set.
Bye bye.
Nervous. I mean, it's so exciting, but it is nerve-wracking. You know, I'm so used to being with the rest of the guys. You know, we were together for 5 years, and everything's all new now, and it's all changed. Now it's all eyes on me, and it's like, oh my God, where are my friends gone? Right, we've just done the first setup, and they're now changing the camera position, which is going to take about 25 minutes. So I've got to go into makeup again and hair and all that malarkey. No, but I think it went really well, apart from the fact that I've been looking up. So it was quite strange sort of looking up, and when your natural position is to sort of look head on. But I think it's going well so far so good. When we were in weren't S Club, it was kind of very much jeans and t-shirts, which was really nice because it was just fun and young and whatever. And now, because I'm getting older, I want to sort of, I'm really into my fashion and my clothes, so I want to sort of experiment with stuff and try new things.
Come in and let me show you what we've got. So Rachel Starr, we're making a video. It's a really long day. We start at 7 in the morning, work all the way through to like 12 at night. Like, Rachel likes graphic stuff. It makes my job really, really easy. She doesn't like things that are like too over the top. She doesn't like lots of chiffon and colour. She likes things streamlined and just really, really easy and what works for her. As you walk down by. Here's some sorted little knickers that I made earlier. But as you see, they're quite sophisticated, you know, a really nice white bow that kind of harks back to the 50s. Black again, and I'm going to match that with like a long sleeve Gucci top, so she's all nice and covered on top. Then she, you know, she's got some legs to show as well. We've got some bling bling earrings, a nice dog tag. But for the ultimate bling bling, we've got this. Attach it to her trousers. She's going to have it slashed all the way up, and as she turns around the turntable, it's going to flash in the light. Wow, that's quite a look, I'd say. Okay, so now we've taken off all the plastic sheeting off the main set and we're just waiting for Rachel. So this is going to be her with a whole lot of light effects happening around her. We've done the close-ups, which look amazing, and this is just a wide shot of what's going to happen next.
It is a dream come true, and it's all new, and it's like starting all over again and a new challenge, and it's like one of the biggest challenges I've ever had to do in my life, to be honest. It's always interesting to sort of watch it back to see what you like and what you don't like. So, you know, not to do that again or whatever. So, yeah, that's it's really good to know. It helps, definitely helps. End of day one, it's a wrap, and I'm going home to bed because I'm very tired, but it went fantastically well, and I'll see you tomorrow. Okay.